can see, Sparky.
As you do.
This suit is so hot.
Yeah.
Oh, hi, Booze and Ghouls. I didn't see you guys there because I can't see anything because I'm a shark, which connects to this movie's for Shark Week perfectly because we're going to do a little film called Razorback. It's about a pig.
Okay, so straight up, like, yeah, we're just doing this because we felt like, when else are we going to talk about Razorback? This isn't a full-blown Jaws knockoff, but when the fuck else are we going to talk about this movie? And I love this movie, so, yeah. Oh my god, Jaws Unleashed was Razorback the whole time. damn shark genie.
I don't know,
this concept's wearing very thin very fast. So Razorback.
It had been a while since I had seen this one, guys. And it was interesting.
I love this movie.
I know you do.
What do you like about the movie?
I didn't say I didn't like it. It's I do have a con. I think the movie's a little too long.
I think it's paced pretty well, actually.
There's a few dead spots.
My only real problem with the movie is, and granted, you would have to also rename the movie from Razorback to something else. But the opening of our movie, it's a great way to open the movie, but it kind of removes any sense of intrigue we have about the story, because the whole crux of this movie, we open with somebody putting their little cute baby to bed, and then a fucking boar rams through his house and kills his baby.
And
everybody in the area thinks he killed the kid.
Yeah. It's in Australia.
Yeah. So you have this whole crux of the movie of, like, a lot of people thinking he killed the kid and everything, whereas we as the audience know, no, it was a pig, and it's called Razorback anyway. So then we jump to America, where we have this animal rights news reporter lady?
Yeah.
Who's just gonna
have her first anniversary, and she gets called on an assignment, and her husband gives her an early anniversary present, a ring.
She dies.
She dies. You know, as soon as she gets the ring,
yeah,
she does
interviews. The locals attempt to rape her, but then the pig stops her because while this pig is a murderer, it is very anti-rape.
Which is good on the pig.
Which is good on the pig. And then it kills and eats her.
He's like Wilbur. He's a good pig.
Wilbur's pissed. and then he kills and eats her.
Stopped a rape.
He did stop a rape, and then her husband, the movie, we follow her husband trying to find out what happened to her in Australia, and his past intersects with the man who's the pig killed his bebe.
Yeah.
As you do. That's the basic crux of this story. Overall, I love this movie. I think this movie's really fun, excellent exploitation film. It's a very fun creature feature that actually, like, the cinematography is incredibly well shot. Like, I did not remember, there's some really gorgeous fucking shots in this movie. The score's really good. The performances are all good. The effects,
they look good for the time.
Initially, the pig, you can very clearly, was a car, and then they just dressed up a little bit. But once you actually see the actual stationary pig, it looks pretty good. They know it's very much like the shark in Jaws. They use it very sparingly, and they hide it well in shadows and everything. So it doesn't look the greatest, but it doesn't look bad in the movie context.
I think for the time it was pretty good.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, the time was good. Do I have any other cons? Like I said, I just felt, I was a little bored with this one. There were chunks that I would have cut out and just made it a little faster because I was like, been there, done that, know what's going to happen. Which I guess you can say for any movie,
yeah.
But this one in particular.
There's one weird thing about this movie that some people probably could have. I'm moving this. I can't talk good. There's something I think some people probably would have an issue with. This movie is a weird mesh of kind of Death Wish and a creature feature.
Yeah.
Again, much like we did with another movie, like, it's a weird mix of the two.
Yeah, it is.
Because it's more so focused on, like, having run-ins with the people who tried to rape his wife. He doesn't find out about that till the very end of the movie, but he has continuing run-ins, and they're more the villains of the movie than the actual pig.
Yeah, I would agree with that. You could ask, who is the real pigs?
As it were.
Yeah.
I had a pipe. It shares a lot of similarities with, like, Hogzilla, which was basically the American remake of this, and Boar from a few years ago, which was kind of the Australian remake of this.
Yeah.
I do think I like this better than either of those films, but they all have kind of the same overarching problem of it. It almost works, but they have this weird thing of trying to blend other genres and a creature feature, whereas they should just focus on being a fun creature feature, in my opinion.
Yeah, I would agree with you on that. It's just, it's for me, it was slow, and like I said, my biggest problem was the pacing. I was kind of bored.
I was never really bored with it. I do really like this movie, but I can say there are issues with it. It is not a perfect film.
No, it's more of a fun popcorn kind of, you know, lay back on the couch, you know, nothing. We don't have anything else to watch.
Yeah.
So, you know, I wouldn't say this is the worst thing to do. If you're like creature features, it's a perfectly fun ride. For me, though, I was like, okay. You know.
I get that.
Sparky?
Yeah.
Well, I look like a jackass since we're talking about a pig movie and I'm dressed up like a shark. Do you think people will think this?
No, I mean, it's Shark Week. We're celebrating Jaws, but,
with
Shark.
With a pig.
Shark Genie, cursed us, so we have to review Jaws knockoffs. However that works, and it happened off screen because we didn't come up with this Shark Genie idea until like halfway through this week. Shut up, you don't hear any of this. Ignore the man behind the curtain. As for what we're doing tomorrow, well, shit, we're out of all Jaws related media. We've talked about all four films. We've reviewed both video games. I don't know. So, tomorrow we'll talk about the book?
Could I dress like a hooker tomorrow? For Shark Week? A hooker shark?
I don't know, but tune in tomorrow for something that admittedly probably won't have anything to do with Jaws.
So, with all that out of the way, boos and ghouls, as always, we thank you so much for watching. We love each and every one of your faces. And if you're new around here and happen to like the content of this channel and want to see me in a slut shark suit...
How do you do that?
I'm working that out in my head right now. Then you better hit that subscriber button because I don't think any other horror channel will give you a slutty shark for Shark Week. A hooker shark, if you will. I wonder if that's ever been made. Anyway, as always, boos and ghouls, thank you so much for watching. We wish you all a very good day, a good evening, and we'll talk to you guys real soon. We'll talk to you later, kiddos. Shark. I'm gonna be a slutty shark tomorrow.
See you tomorrow for the last thing of Shark Week.
I'm gonna get all the
makeup. Every year it gets weirder and weirder.